Steve Dotto here. How the heck are we at this fine day? Me, I am a bit road weary, if the truth be known, having just returned from about a 16-day junket out to Chicago, New York, Boston, just all places east of where I live here in Vancouver, but home safe and sound and eager to get back to answering your questions today on Ask Dotto Tech. Well, we've reached the ninth episode of Ask Dotto Tech. I am thrilled that you folks are asking me lots of questions in our YouTube channel. Now, if you have a technical question that you want me to try and answer, I can't answer each and every question that's asked, but I do my best. Just make sure you post it in our comments area here in YouTube, and I will do my best to get to it. And I think we should just dive in. We've got lots of Evernote stuff to talk about today, and a few other things as well. And it's good because I'm working on a lot of Evernote things. We're redoing our Evernote Made Easy course as we speak, so it's kind of top of mind for me. So Dave Coleman, who is not really a chimpanzee, I don't imagine, even though his avatar seems to indicate that he is one, says, Steve, I am new to Evernote, 2 to 3 weeks in and still learning, and YouTube sites are great for my training, even better than Evernote is. But as I am at this moment still a basic user, how do I know how much of the maximum 64 megabytes are left for me for this or any month? So simple, David, but thank you for asking the question. If you go into your desktop app for Evernote and you go under the Evernote menu, going into your account info will bring up the status of your account, and it will tell you how much data you can upload for the remainder of this month. Now, I wouldn't worry too much about your 64 megabytes of space. I think that's how much the Evernote gives. The times that I was a free user, I never, ever came close to using the maximum. Now, I guess you can, and I'm sure there are people that do come close to the maximum, but you can store an awful lot of data in Evernote, the way that Evernote's structured. So, but if you are concerned, that is exactly how you do it. Just go into your account settings under the account menu, or under the Evernote menu, and you will be there. And thank you, David, for that fine question. Next up is Book Lover. Thanks for the video. I have a doubt. Book Lover, I gotta tell you, I have so many doubts. But let's deal with your specific doubt, shall we? If we clip a web article and the article is removed from the internet, will the article still be in our Evernote, or capital G-O-N-E, gone? Because there are many important infos are saved in my Evernote, I'd hate to get bad news when I can't do anything but lose info. So basically, concerned that when you're using the Evernote web clipper, that when you store something, if that information is removed from the web, it will also be removed from Evernote. And I can put your mind at ease, a Book Lover. It will not be. Let's just jump over. Let's just go to a site here. Love this story. I was just reading it. Social Media Examiner, all about top brands rediscovering YouTube. Good for you, top brands. That's all I have to say about that. Here's how the Evernote web clipper works and how it works in this particular case. When we click on, now, while I'm here, let me point out, you notice I'm in my web browser. I'm in the Chrome browser here. You click here on the Evernote web clipper in order to bring up the web clipper. We've dealt with this in the past. Sometimes people go, it doesn't work for me, Steve, when I do it. That's because you're clipping in the Evernote tool that's been installed in your operating system. This is a system tool for creating instant notes in Evernote. It's different, even though the elephant icon looks identical, it's different to the one that ends up in your menu bar of your browser when you install the Evernote web clipper, just as an aside. But here, when we click on the elephant icon, bringing up our web clipper, here are the different options that we have for clipping information into Evernote. We can choose to clip the article, which is going to clip this information here, and you can always see it highlighted, the information that's going to be clipped. You can clip the simplified article, which strips out all of the advertising and ancillary information. You can clip the full page, which puts everything in, or you can clip the bookmark. These first three of them, article, simplified article, and full page, if the page changes or leaves the internet, it will still be retained in your Evernote account. You will still have all of the information. If, however, you choose to clip the kind of the minimum amount of information and just clip the bookmark, then if the site changes, if they change the information at the referring URL, you will lose that information because all you've got is a link. You don't have the information actually clipped. With all of these, you actually have the information clipped and stored in Evernote. It takes up a little bit more storage, referring back to the amount of storage you have in Evernote. It takes up a little bit more space, but you will have all the information. So you definitely want to do one of those. Now, and also all links and all hyperlinks within the page are active as well in Evernote. Having said all of that, if you choose a screenshot, that will just take a graphic of the page, and it will be a static image, but that will also be retained, of course. So those are the different options that you have, and I have. Oh gosh, I'm caught trapped in screen capture mode. There we go. Those are the options that you have, book lover. If you are concerned that you will lose the data, you will not if you choose one of those first three methods for clipping information from the web into Evernote. Thank you so much for that fine question. Next up, we have a question from Satyasam108, who says, Hi. If I do not have access to the internet, does this mean I do not have access to my notes? Is there a way I can store my notes exclusively on my tablet with Evernote? Yes, indeed there is, and that's a darn good question. Now, let me explain how Evernote stores information, and then I'll show you how you deal with it on your mobile. When we create an Evernote account, we store it on our local computer, whatever host computer we have, and then it's mirrored to the cloud services on Evernote. That's the syncing that goes back and forth between Evernote and the service. What happens then is all of the notes that are in our Evernote synced services online then get synced to our mobile devices, which traditionally have a lot less storage than do our computers. So that's why we need access to the internet, either through mobile services or through Wi-Fi, in order to access our notes when we're on our smartphones. Having said all that, before I show you how to make sure that you can get access to your notes when you're offline on your phone, there's a second type of notebook that Evernote allows us to create. And if we go to create a new notebook, let me just show you how to create a new notebook and show you what exactly happens. When you go to create a new notebook, you can choose to create either a synchronized notebook or a local notebook. And you have to do this from this menu. If you just go new notebook, it will automatically create what's called a synchronized notebook. Now, a synchronized notebook works exactly as I just mentioned. It syncs all of the content through the web services, and then it will sync to your smartphone. If for security purposes, you don't want the information that's being stored in that notebook shared online, you're dealing with personal information, banking information, tax information, client information, something that you'd be concerned if it got into other people's hands would cause you an issue, then you can choose to create a local notebook, and then the information is only stored in Evernote on your local computer. It's far less convenient as far as a lot of the convenience of having access to your information wherever you are and on whatever device you're on with Evernote, but it creates an additional level of security and still allows you to use Evernote. So that's the kind of the basic setup as far as notebooks. If you do have a synchronized notebook and you want to have access to it, say when you're on an airplane flight and you don't have access to the internet, how we do that is you do that on device by device. So you go into your Evernote on whichever device, be it a tablet, be it a mobile phone, you go into Evernote and you choose which of your notebooks you want to have stored locally. And you want to be careful about this because it will take up memory on your phone and you can run out of space pretty quickly if you're not careful about exactly what you're saving. But if we go into our notebooks and let's say I want to store this new Evernote Made Easy notebook which I'm creating right now. This is my new course, my new online course content. If I wanted to store that on this device, if I want to have all the information available to us offline, you go to the little three dots down at the very bottom, which brings up your options, and you go into notebook info, and there we have a toggle switch allowing us to make it available online, offline, or not available offline. Now this one the default is to be not available offline. That's the default right there. But I, as you can see with this particular one, made it available offline, so even when I don't have access to Wi-Fi, I have access to the notes in this notebook. Does that make sense? I think it does. And thank you so much for that. So thank you for that question, Satyasam. I think I would like to move off of Evernote for just a few moments, and let's talk about a very serious issue. Let's talk about backing up our computers. And Mark NF82 says, first off, I want to thank you for all the support and entertainment your shows and YouTubes have provided over the years. I've been watching since the old cafe days and have learned a great deal. My old TV show, Dotto's Data Cafe. Fortunately or unfortunately, I have a quick question about backups. He does tech support for a lot of seniors and computer illiterate people who are rightfully concerned about their data once I explain to them what can happen. For years, he's been trying to find a set and forget backup option that will work for them. Usually he sets up Time Machine with an external USB for Mac users, which is a terrific option. However, I've tried many Windows-based solutions that have confused my clients and usually stop working for various reasons. You know, Time Machine does too. It finally gets filled, and you have to be careful as far as that goes. Is there any software or hardware-based solutions that you'd recommend? Also, where does Time Machine sit in backing up? Is it a good solution recommended or just meh? Well, it's more than meh, but it's not the end-all, be-all. Backing up is a delicate situation, and you really have to have, I believe, at least two backup options going for you at all times. You've got your local backup, which you store in usually in the same area as is your computers. And then I think you have to have an offsite backup solution as well. So for your local onsite backup, if you are on the Mac, the Time Machine does work well, but you have to maintain it. You have to keep checking to make sure you're not running out of space, because once it runs out of space, obviously there's no place for it to store new files and it's got to delete older ones. And there are issues. And I've had Time Machine working fine, it seemingly, for a couple of years, and then all of a sudden had issues when I've gone in to look at it. So it's something that you have to maintain and check, I think, on a fairly regular basis, which is probably not in the sweet spot of your seniors. So having said that, I think probably for most of us that really want to have just a set and forget backup system, an online backup system is going to be the best. And there's a couple of different options out there, and I can't speak to which one is better because I've tested out iDrive. I actually have an affiliate relationship with iDrive, which I'm not going to give you the link for in this because I haven't looked at it recently enough to be able to actually firmly recommend it. But I think they've got a good reputation and they've done a good job. And it costs... It's a little bit misleading. It costs about $80, $90 a year for a proper size backup, for like 1 terabyte of backup space. The other option, I believe, has unlimited backup space, and it's a well-thought-of solution. It's called Carbonite, and it costs $60 to $100 a year as well for backing up a single computer. If you really want a set-and-forget system, I think one of these online systems is the best, as long as you make sure that your clients or the people that you're supporting understand how the account works, what their relationship is with these folks, and they have a good, robust internet account, because the first backup is good, always takes a long time with these because it's got to go online to back up everything. After the first backup, it's just incremental. Anything that changes gets backed up. But I think these are probably the most reliable solutions. I think we will wrap things up now for this week's episode of Ask Dotto Tech. My thanks to everybody who left questions. And if you have a question for me to answer, please post it in the comments area here in YouTube. I read those comments each and every day. And if I can answer your question, I will do my best to get it here on the show. Dotto Tech is brought to you by Blockless. End regional limitations to browsing the internet. Visit my friends at Blockless and discover what true free browsing is all about. Until next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.